אבא, אנחנו מודים לך על היום הזה. תודה רבה על הברכה שאתה שולח אלינו מדי יום ביומו, אבא. תודה על אלה שבאים להשתחוות לפניך כאן, אבא. אנחנו מודים לך בשם ישוע המשיח. מודים לך, אבא, על הנוכחות שלך כאן, אבא.
She was met by this demon-possessed man, and the demon-possessed man said to him, "Lord, did you come here to trouble us?" And Jesus said, "What is your name?" He was actually addressing the demons, and they answered, "Legion." And then they pleaded with the Lord and said to the Lord, "Lord, please do not send us back to hell. Napakalinit doon. It is very hot in hell. Please do not send us back to hell. Send us to the pigs." And Jesus gave a command, "Go." And the demons went to the pigs, and the pigs ran down the slope and they drowned into the sea. Okay, so that of the Sea of Galilee. Jesus did not go to Tiberias often. He did not go to Decapolis because the people that were living there were the pagan Greeks. In fact, the Jew at that time would not enter the house of a Gentile because they're considered to be unclean because of their pagan ways. So Jesus concentrated his ministry right here in the northern end, because here in the northern end was the place where the Jews used to live. The Jews lived only on the northern end of the Sea of Galilee. And Jesus said, "I came for the lost sheep of Israel." And so he concentrated his time among the Jews right here in the northern end of the Sea of Galilee. Now, first of all, I'd like you to look to your left. Wait, over here. See that mountain, the Mount Arbel? At the foot of that mountain is actually Magdala, right? Remember? And then directly across Magdala, you look here, and you see a green patch over there. Can you see the green patch? There's a lot of green patch over there. That is Bethsaida. Bethsaida. Jesus, actually, during the last 3 years of his life, spent most of the time between Magdala and Bethsaida. He did not travel all over the place around the Sea of Galilee, but he devoted his time between Magdala and Bethsaida because that's the places where the Jews used to live. Now I want you to get up. Get up, arm to Magdala. So you are all stretch, okay? Do it, my dears. Within your arms right now, 80% of Jesus' words were spoken. Within your arms right now, 2/3 of the gospel took place. And within your arms right now, 22 out of the 35 recorded miracles of the Lord took place. Now you can put it down. Now this is really something, because you see here that we are such a small place over here. Jesus said, "I came for the lost sheep of Israel." 2/3 of the gospel took place between Magdala and Bethsaida. 80% of Jesus' words were spoken between Magdala and Bethsaida. Also, 22 out of the 35 recorded miracles of the Lord took place between Magdala and Bethsaida. It is such a small area. Jesus was obedient to the command of the Father that I came for the lost sheep of Israel. So he performed the most miracles only in this small area. Jesus remained faithful to what God had commanded him to do, and yet the impact is far-reaching. Even though the gospel was preached only in this small area, it reached the farthest islands of the Philippines, the farthest jungles of Africa, and the farthest corner of the world. Even though it is just a small place, the starting point. Now we have to learn from the Lord. We are never to despise the seemingly small and insignificant things of life. Whatever the Lord has given you to do, do not consider it as too small. We are to be faithful in the little things that God has given us. And as we are faithful to the things that God has given us, the impact can be far-reaching. You never know whom God is going to use. It could all be, could very well be your own children. Now, right now, we are here in this place. It's very quiet. The sea is quiet right now. But in a storm, it is very frightening where we are right now. Why? Because over here, can you see this mountain over here, Mount Arbel? Usually the storms come from the Mediterranean Sea. It crosses all of Israel. And then it enters the Sea of Galilee on this side. And you can see that there is a mountain, and there's a small opening there, a small opening between the two mountains. When the winds would come through between these two mountains, the force of the wind is much stronger. The smaller the opening, the stronger is the force of the wind. And so the storms usually take place where we are right now. And so it can be frightening, and I have seen it myself. And the waves are so high. And while the other parts of the sea can be very peaceful, but over here where we are right now can be frightening. And we remember the Lord when there was a storm. What was he doing?
Sleeping.
He was asleep. And they had to wake him up and said, "Lord, don't you care that we perish?" Jesus woke up and he says, "Oh, ye of little faith, why did you doubt?" And then afterwards, then he commanded the winds to be quiet. So what do you say? Be quiet? Check it. So he commanded the winds to cease. Be quiet. Check it. And then the wind ceased, and then there was calm. And so they saw that Jesus has authority over the winds and the storms. This is also the place where Jesus walked on water, and also the place where Peter walked on water. Now is that you, Lord? And the Lord said, "It is I, Peter." And then, "If that is you, Lord, let me come to you." And he said, "Come, Peter." And he came, and then he was looking at the Lord. And then when he took his eyes off the Lord and started looking at the waves, then he started to sink. Okay, we are at this place again, you know. We do have storms in our lives. Sometimes it can sweep you off, right? There are times that we have gone through some trials in our lives. It sweeps you off the ground. And the Lord did promise that he said, and he did not promise that there would be no storms in our lives, but he did promise that he will be with us as we go through the storm. His presence is there when we go through the storm. And we are definitely gonna go through storms. I think you agree with that, right? You have your own experiences of storms in your own lives. Okay. Now, I want you to meet the crew here. First of all, somebody is hiding his head. First, I'd like you to meet Rami. This is Rami, and he is the gifted musician, Rami, and he will be playing music for us right beside. Yes.
From the grandfathers to the fathers to the one of the grandchildren.
Okay, yes, the grandfather.
He's the older.
He's the older one. And then we have Doron. Say hello to Doron. And then this is he is younger than you.
I'm 10 years older than him.
Oh really? Now this is Daniel. Daniel is the captain and the owner of this boat. Daniel Carmel, I told you about him, the Messianic Jew. We have Shai. Shai is not shy.
Yeah, that's my baby. Yeah, shy. And then also, where's Eliezer? Eliezer is over here. Okay, so we have the crew, and they'll be playing some music for us. And so we'll worship the Lord, and I'll give the phone now, the microphone to Daniel. As I mentioned to you before, Daniel is a believer in Jesus. He's a Jew, he's a Messianic Jew, and he loves the Lord, and he has a special gift of worship.
Shalom Mate!
Shalom Mate!
How are you today? All excited?
Yes!
Who is first time on the Sea of Galilee? Raise your hand. All of you! So you must be excited, huh? Because you know, I'm 20 years I'm here, I'm excited every day, day by day, you know. Some people, as a Romema, how do you call her, Romema or Exi?
Exi.
Well, in Hebrew we call her Romema. So Romema told you, I'm a believer, and that's right. And actually, the company, the boats company, Sea of Galilee Worship Boats, is the only company that belongs to believers in Yeshua HaMashiach, in Jesus, on the Lake of Galilee. And the name of this boat is?
Faith.
That's right. So you are actually sailing on faith. Eh? What do you say about that? And we have another one. The name is Hope. And we are praying to bring love. Love will be the greatest of all. Amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And my name is Daniel, as you already know. And I came to know Yeshua on the lake. Yeshua is the name of Jesus in Hebrew. So I came to know him on the lake during my work as a boat captain. And you know, I will tell you my whole life story, but then you'll be late for breakfast tomorrow. You know why I love Philippines? Yeah, I tell you what, I cut the story for a moment. I tell you, by my statistics, Philippines are the most happy people on the face of the earth.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Is that right? All right. So, where were I? I don't remember. So anyway, after I met Yeshua, Jesus, I started translating very popular worship songs to Hebrew. Why? Because Hebrew is his language. Also, I believe that we all will have to speak Hebrew there. So if you don't know Hebrew, you better start learning it here. Huh? Romema? Any special request today?
Oh, I told you about my favorite song, right? The one. And so I hope that you would be blessed to hear it. The one. Jesus is the one.
Amen. Hallelujah.
שלום בשם ישוע המשיח, אמן.
הלו